Hi guys, I'm glad you're here. Thank you for joining me once again. You can help me out by sharing my videos and subscribing. There by the Salton Sea, it's been a rocking and a rolling. There's been 53 earthquakes within the last week, the largest being a magnitude 3.6, which occurred yesterday, and also a 2.5. The 3.6 occurred at 11:54 Pacific Standard Time. 33 people said they felt the earthquake. Intensity level 4, meaning it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few, at night, or if they were napping, because it wasn't nighttime. They would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, and doors were probably rattling, and automobiles rocking noticeably. Now, the location of this earthquake was probably actually along the San Andreas Fault Zone. Yeah, it's pretty darn wide, and you can see it drawn out in blue and in red. And also, we have the San Jacinto Fault Zone. But this is where the earthquakes have been occurring, closer to the San Andreas Fault Zone. Now, the 2.5 was at 11:54 a.m., as was the 3.6. Yeah, that's interesting that they happened within a short period of time. Boom, boom. Five people said they felt that earthquake, and USGS gave it an intensity level of 3. Now, the 3.6, which had an intensity level of 4, let's go to the felt reports. And it was felt as far north. Let's bring this in. As Riverside, yeah, Los Angeles, California. We've talked about, or I've talked about, how if the fault rips coming up from this area, going up through the mountains, how it's a choke hold, and then it would, the energy would spray out, widen out in the Los Angeles area, which are where it was also felt. It would be devastating if the fault zone ripped going from south to north. Now, for the magnitude 3.6, USGS did not fudge about the size of it. It actually was a magnitude 3.6. And we'll go to its seismic signature. It took me forever to get different stations that were actually working. And I did download 3 different stations. Let me bring this over for you. Right there. This one actually shows a lot more earthquakes. But we got data for some reason. The monitor stopped working. But there was a lot of them. Prior to this 3.6 earthquake, we have at least 5 here that are marked in red. That means the computer picked it up, designated this area close to the location of the monitor, sends a text message to the geologist. Earlier, there was one at 18:54. They did fudge about that one. They're claiming that that earthquake was a magnitude 2.5. They're way off on that one. This here is a larger of the 5 that is marked in red, and I'll bring it down so you can see. It was actually a magnitude 3.30, and we'll go to its seismic signature and bring it back up for you to see. The next largest one was at 19:30 and 55 seconds. For some reason, they said it was 19:34, but that would actually be at the end of this earthquake. Yeah, I have no idea where they got that one from, the time. They were off on the time, and they're also off on the size. They said it was a magnitude 1.2, but it comes in as a magnitude 2.80, and I'll bring it down. See that? 2.80. The next largest one would probably be this one right here. At 20:25 and 40 seconds, somewhere in there. There's a spectrogram for it. This one they're not even reporting. This one comes in as a magnitude 2.59. Yeah, they're not even reporting it. Let me bring it back up. 2.59. There's its seismic signature. All right, so the next one would probably be this one right here. Let me bring it over. At 21:22, USGS is saying it's a 1.8, but in actuality, let me bring it down, it comes in as a 1.94. And then, let me bring it back up. Boy, they're off. Only this one have they even been correct on. The next small one marked in red, which actually looks like two earthquakes maybe. Let's look at the seismic signature. Nope, it's one long one. A long P wave, which means it was a little bit of distance from where this earthquake occurred. But that one comes in as a magnitude 2.08, and they are not reporting that one either. Let me double check. Okay, let me go back to the seismic signature. We'll get the time, 2045. Yep, they never even reported it. And then there was another very small one I thought I saw here. No, I guess not. All right, let's bring it down. Yeah, see, I got data missing. Did I do this one? Right there. No, I did not. At 9:48. That is for today, July 15th. They're saying that that one is a 1.6. We'll look at the spectrogram. And I really shortened up the seismic signature, but it still comes in as a 1.94. We'll go to its signature, 1.94. Recently, when I pulled the files at 18:10 and 25 seconds, we got this other small earthquake. That one not being reported, it comes in as a magnitude 1.50. Once again, I shortened the seismic signature. Yeah, a lot more than what it should have been. It should have been probably right there. So we'll go there, and we'll go there. Oh, let's go back to it so you can see. It would be a 1.66 then, but that's where it's actually supposed to be. And it's not being reported. Here on USGS, you can see that there's a lot of earthquakes along the San Jacinto. And then, like I said, it goes, the San Andreas goes up towards the north from here, goes up and comes around. Yeah, a lot of earthquakes right now. And, yeah, it's like, oh my goodness. Oh, we got a quarry blast. I just had a quarry blast. This one here is a 0.8. They're off. They are off so much on these earthquakes. 0.6, a 1.4, a 1.2. Yeah, another. Now, these would be considered San Andreas right through here. Another 1.2. Yeah, they are way off. A total so far in the last week, 294 earthquakes. Oh my goodness. I hope everyone is prepared because they are overdue down here in the south for a major earthquake. And like I said, you do not want the San Andreas fault zone. You could have a large one on the San Jacinto to trigger the San Andreas fault zone. You do not want it going from south to north. So, what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing my videos. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you.